Next, we're going to the bully of the Big Ten. Your conference, your division, y'all got a lot of divisional games. You got a lot of conference games going on week one. Ohio State is going on the road in the Big Ten to play Minnesota. Now, a couple of years ago, Minnesota was a premier team in the Big Ten. People were looking to make a lot of noise. Many of those guys have graduated. Many of those guys have moved on. How good is this Minnesota team? How good is this Ohio State team that's reloading? Because they don't really rebuild there. Ohio State, this line opened at 14. It is still minus 14. Two touchdown favorite on the road. What you got?
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting. Minnesota, they're trying to get over a bad year last year. But the problem with this game is what Minnesota does best is run the ball. They got Muhammad Ibrahim. He's one of the best returning running backs in the Big Ten. That offensive line can run block left, right, and sideways. You know, they're going to run the ball. They're going to run the ball well. The weakness in the Ohio State defense, I think, is in the secondary. I think if you're able to throw the ball, if you're able to challenge that secondary deep, I think that's where Ohio State's going to have trouble. So what Minnesota's strength is, isn't necessarily Ohio State's weakness. So I think, you know, Ohio State has all the talent of the world. Yeah, they have a first-time quarterback, C.J. Stroud getting the nod right off the bat, but their wide receivers are excellent. I'm not in love with Minnesota's defense. 14 points on the road. Ohio State rarely starts the season on the road, so this is definitely interesting, and a lot of eyes are going to be on this game. Yeah, 14 points for the Buckeyes. I think that's about right. I could see them winning by more.
Yeah, I could see that. I could see it as well. I do think the number is right. And I'm going to tell you this. I think all these numbers are about as sharp to a point as they're going to be. Okay? The lines have been out for a long time. I'm of the opinion that if every sharp bettor out there has already made all their plays. Any action going forward is going to mostly be either the public or sharps getting back in if a line has a lot of drastic movement one way or another. I don't think you're going to find a whole lot of extra edges coming out of these things. These bookmakers have got these numbers to a T.